In my topic, I will describe some offensive security related to banking malware. I'm in company CSIS, mostly working with banking malware. We have a lot of clients in banks, mostly in Europe, but also in UK. We have also a lot of clients, huge banks and corporation in Ukraine, in UK. And they usually offensive security. It happens when our clients understand that they lose a lot of money, and they want to do something against banking malware to prevent their losses. They start to make some calls and invite law enforcement. And from our side, we provide our investigation, provide to them information firstly, to mitigate losses, but it will be success if we find the guys who is behind this banking malware to track the criminals and make a court against them. First introduction about me: I'm started posting at 2010. Yeah, I'm started posting on blog about investigation of APT attacks. There was exploit libtif, maybe you know. It was not made by me, but I'm published reliable code. It was found on some APT attack against huge US corporation and US universities. And I published it exploit, and it was probably my mistake. I never do this anymore because the criminals start using this exploit everywhere. And I'm also a member of DeepEnd Research Project, DCC, Digital Crime Community, and HoneyNet Project. Now I'm working in CCS Security Group. It's a Danish company. I told you that for what we are doing, it's mostly B2B business. We provide to huge companies, provide consulting, help them to secure. In my topic, I will firstly describe like general banking malware, how it works, what they use, and show some exploits which is related to most popular banking malware like Zeus, Citadel, and some other, which is still active, and a lot of people use Zeus, I know, in US and like everywhere. We even tracking a lot of groups. And then I show to you a story about such malware as Deriza, and what we can do, because this is most hard to do with malware when it's related to some closed group, and really hard to find some information in internet, in public. You cannot find panel, and even cannot find sometimes you cannot find even backend server. They usually use a lot of front end. Sometimes even they in other malware they can use even P2P. This is just general overview of banking malware. It's I'm thinking that a lot of you have in touch at least reversing or something, understanding banking malware. It's usually user which have access to internet banking and then intercept in browser credentials when user try to log it in bank. They grabbing credentials. Sometimes they also popular. They use web injects. It's written in JavaScript to cheat user. On example, they show on page if that bank secured with one-time password or SMS message. They just ask a user to enter these credentials, and most advanced web inject, they fully automatically make transfer in user browser that bank just sees that was transfer made from real computer, real user computer, but a user just sees some like infected client, just see only fake web page where he asked for some password. Most simple web inject is just like on bank site or some PayPal site, for example, like money transfer site, they are asking for credit card number, sometimes other details. But for us in my report, it's what is interesting, like I'm focused how to get more information about banking malware. It's banking malware uses like DGA, it's domain generation algorithm. It's for one thing, it's so they are a bit criminals protect themselves. If one domain will be blocked, they can register another domain. As this was used in not only banking malware, even was used in CryptoLocker. But from our perspective, it's good because then we can also register domain, and all the infected computers will also connect to our domain. But it's so some malware, banking malware, like for example, HesperBot, Gozi, or Omnix, they do not make verification of command and control server. And if after everything, if you know all the protocol, you can grab all credentials which will be sent to sinkhole. And you can get all data, all compromised data. But now, other malware like Tinba, it's Tiny Bunker, it's another name. It's and also was Remnit. They make a verification based on ISA, a verification of command and control server. And was also it's in what we just one time was used. There was like Dridex, Deriza, they use infected routers. They just brute force password on routers. It can be home routers and even like some housewife or even like my mother or your mother just like have router at home with default password, and criminals scan, and then on routers they using IP tables and forward all traffic from open ports like what they want, and forward all traffic to the backend server. And this really hard to block because routers it can stay like everywhere, and even owner of routers they don't know nothing about that if their router was infected. And to remove such router, it's also really hard because it's need to go to everyone to home and to ask to make a full like full reset of router, and it's really complicated. And also that for banking malware, it's used like bulletproof servers. Even there was we seen in some months ago that criminals even registered own ISP. It was registered in Baileys, but really operated by Russians. And simple way, it's hacked website, but it's usually used only for like not really smart, like script kiddies. They use it for phishing and even spam from that servers. And for phishing, you even can get they usually even store that zip file with all the phishing stuff, like with the phishing kit. In that server, you just need to just add to that folder just dot zip, and you can like in 50% you can get all the phishing kit and credentials where it's sent or where it's stored data. And what to do with malware that, as usual, we just when we get from forensic cases, malware, it's our clients, like banks, for example, they if they know they lost money and in fact, like client complains that it's not was my transfer, that banks send to clients our software, which like forensic software, which is grabbing all information, all important executables files, like from OutRun, from other stuff, and send to us, and we analyzing. It's usually it's simple, like say same malware. But sometimes we found it's totally new samples, like totally new campaign. It was we found Tiny Bunker, then we found Dira or Diriza. It's also we firstly like one of the first investigated this malware. Even Diriza, first samples was with debug string with debug information. But it's to. Like to provide this to start like make investigation make much more like to try to attack criminals. It's complicated because you need firstly to cooperate like talk with law enforcement because we are just white security company and we need to do a huge work before we can start doing something. Banks usually they after they lose a lot of money they only then understand that we need to do something. But at the beginning, when it's criminals only starting, they have a lot of bugs. But they usually they don't want don't approve us for that stuff. But we also cooperating with a lot of search law enforcement companies, and if it's attack and bank or law enforcement approve us, we cooperate with ISP, can ask them to get sniff traffic from that server because sometimes it's usually front end server and on front end server. It's not always that some info stored on servers. There can be a reverse proxy on Nginx, or all information can be encrypted with TrueCrypt. And if even get a dump of server, you get nothing, only like TrueCrypt volume on what stored like all important information. But it's really hard to brute force password. Like for example, for Diriza, they have a script which automatically creates this TrueCrypt volume, and password is 20 characters. It's for with our resources, it's impossible to brute force it. And but many times that ISP, like hosting providers, when they understand this is a criminals hosted, they agree to cooperate with us. They provide even dump of servers. But it's mostly based on personal connection, like on conferences, on personal meetings. We know each other and they trust us and they provide information to us when we asking them. This about syncholing, like syncholing, this is like all banking malware, they mostly they have some command and control servers. And it's usually connected by domain, and if it's not DGA, we also cooperating like with domain register and ask them can they point their domains to our syncall to our server, and in sometimes we can usually it's only we can get infected IP addresses. But sometimes we can get a lot of drop data. It's data coming from infected computers. This is for an example that related to Hesperbot. There was campaign in Turkey, and there was a huge amount of infected computers. It's in just infected computers, just information for one day. And on this side, it's I don't know you see or not. This is domain generation algorithm. they generate domain, and we just found which domain they use, registers like register point it's on our sinkhole, and ask to block like domain which is used by criminals. Yeah, and now about like Zeus, it was like most popular malware. I don't know how it's in Brazil, but in US and Europe, that used by criminals, by different groups, and it's already was leaked, and you can on different cybercrime forums, like Carders forums, you can easily download panel and builder and create like you just need a hosting and then upload panel, and criminals can just need to infect users. But in panel there exists like bug that you can make a remote command execution at the bot. As you can see, that like extension which are blocked, they are blocked PHP, and panel was written on PHP, and usually you need to upload like to remote command execution, and you just need to insert PHP code or upload it, and it's Zeus have two ways. It can store information in MySQL database and also in on hard drive. It's basically it stores the certificates grab it from user and reports. It's reports on TXT format which grab data. But code and folder where it's stored, it's called slash reports, and then files, and then just name of like name of bot which is generated by Zeus. But you can upload on that also. If you can upload, if you know protocol, you can upload any files, and there was possibly to upload related to configuration of like Unix, Windows, related to the FL system. It's possibly to upload PHP, this PHP file and with dot, or also a PHT file. And then you will find this file stored on the CNC, and you can make a command execution, execute any command, and grab credentials. And criminals that panel will be the same. That criminals will not understand that what you do only by access logs, but it's also you can just get information and then just delete your file. And to make this exploitation, you just from sample you need to know command and control server. It's usually linked to gate PHP. This is a sample we already make fully automated system, and this is URL to gate PHP. It's stored encrypted in executable, and then RC4 key. We like 256 byte of RC4, just full key, and then this is folder reports, which is stored data, and then this file, then botnet name. You can choose what you want. And bot ID, it's and that PHP file. We made that system to fully automate get data, and even we add to control panel, we add some tracking code, and then we can track criminals. It looks like that. And we have like every criminal when he visited already panel, and we set to him a cookie in different way, like in HTML5, like the real cookie, or in also flash cookie, to get track them, and then this is map, like these lines. This is what criminals use, and if lines connected, it's related to one group. And also we are tracking some, like what browsers they use, and a lot of criminals, like only like 50, like Chrome browser, which is have automatically update system, only 15 people have updated, and 474 not update, they don't use even latest version of Google Chrome. And so these other browsers, the same story. A bit forward. And about Citadel, this is what is related to the bot. It doesn't work because they have in another way, they have like a Lovett extension, and other files they store as unknown to dot file. But and also reports folder, it's when installing the Citadel, it's generate at the end double word number, and to hide this folder to automatically try to getting to this folder. But it's criminals not even like in Citadel also leaked and published a via label, but to get like this folder, you can just run install script. Criminals even says in rules about installation of Citadel, they writing you need to delete after installation, delete install folder, but no one do that. And no, some people really do, but not all of them, mostly not. And from reports folder, you can get this reports folder, and if they store all grabbed information as text file, sometimes it's indexing a via label, and was once that we get from server near 100 gigabytes of data just from one campaign. But it's in panel, this bug also available in Zeus, IS9, but also in Citadel. You need to get access to panel. It's possible like brute force cookie or brute force admin password. It's not always complicated. Sometimes it's just like can be admin, but it's depending on success. It's not always we get luck. But in script, in panel, you have access, like you can make a zip file. And they execute just zip command, automatically putting there all parameters, and you can make like writing files. And from that, you can write any files. This command will be executed on server. And upload in such way get remote code execution just like in shell, just write or make a reverse shell like in one command, or just download additional file and get access to server. Because even in Citadel, if it's small campaign, sometimes it's interesting because they can on one server, if it's a bulletproof server, they can store like the 10 different malwares, or even Citadel, like many different campaigns. And also another bug we found is in Pony Loader. It's very popular loader, even used by Dridex and Deriza. It can grab credential from FTP clients, some from email clients, and also like hiddenly download files. And also it Pony Loader was panel and builder, even source code was leaked. And that this loader, it's really small. It's written on FASM. And there are only 20 kilobytes of binary. but this related to authorization. When user try to authorize, it's for user generate a cookie and like with name user ID and store this cookie in database. And if user do not press logout, only exit from browser, its cookie will be stored and they don't have expire date and it will be stored forever. And when we saw that, we investigated and criminals probably mistake because they generated cookie using SHA and multiplying like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with micro time. But micro time that it's execution of this function, it's look like that. And latest, this first is just real number and second is integer. But real number that it's always end with double zero and really you need to brute force like to, and this is like numbers which is interesting for us, it just six numbers and no, just for five numbers. And then what we need to do to get, we just generate a list of 1 million, like near 1 million these cookies. And then start sending request, and if it's doing like or based on threads, if really for it's can be hacked, like Pony Loader panel can be hacked for 30 minutes, like maybe even less. It's depending what hacker, what servers they use. And then if you know this cookie, you cannot log in. You can log in to panel and get all information. And another, it's Gozi 2 or Rovnix, it's also name. It there was it's new panel, it's called IAP, and we firstly seen it was attack, this malware was attacked Norway, our clients in Norway, and we found bug in install PHP. That was to install PHP. When you log it in, you can when it's installed PHP available, you just need to enter like the database credentials, like the database IP address, username, password for database, and admin password. And then it store everything to options PHP file. As you can see in folder DB, and always create the database IAP. But to make a command execution from that, we just sending a request, and in password we put like this quotas and this quotas, and this quota was we will be writing to options PHP. But before, because they firstly check validate database, you need to create this exactly such database and exactly like user with such password. Like on your like if you have own server, it's and allow for MySQL, allow for all people from different IP addresses to connect to that server. And then you can get access to panel. But what we do with like malware, which is like related to some really specific malware related to some attacks, which is not publicly available, that different ways, but really, I even firstly doesn't expect that will be so effective. It's possibly to just send in cross-site scripting because criminals, they are mostly focused to steal money and they doesn't implement even basic security in their scripts. And as they adding usually to fighting with banks, adding new features, they have like implement when they adding they implement new bugs, and for cross-site scripting like to be like to that make it easy, I just use TK domain and buy get certificate, but it's possible even to buy, but I need certificate only for one target group when we approve it to make attack. And this is just script. It's sending URL of admin panel, because you in huge botnets, even P2P botnets, you don't know where is located admin panel. And authorization cookie, mostly everything they're using authorization by cookie, but if they use HTTP authorization, that you cannot grab in such way, that doesn't help, but at least you will know where is panel located. And also we are grabbing all IP addresses using RTC, of criminals, and then we can locate it, from what countries are they, and they start to cooperate. If we know real IP address, we can cooperate with local police and get more information who is behind this malware. But and even in such way, you will get like all IP addresses. But even if user under VPN. And in that way, we get access to Remnet panel. It was, but for now, it's not actual, really, because was a year ago, it was operation made by Microsoft against Remnet with cooperation around like Microsoft, Symantec, and our company. Remnet, it's user DGA. And Microsoft usually to block everything, they just like bought all domains and block it other domains. They just doing simple things. They just get all domains. But before we get information related to various backend servers, where they store information and IP addresses of criminals, they located in Russia, but it's for now it's court, it's still going on, it just was blocked botnet, and it can be not totally effective, because criminals can easily restore access to like infecting another users and like make a new botnet. And that we have, like it was for our clients in UK, was really important, because we get thousands of compromised credit cards, and then this our customers can easy block all credit cards, all compromised credit cards. So, but this about Deriza, it was we firstly investigated, and we firstly we just monitoring them, because they attacking our clients, and they spamming like UK and US, and there was they use we firstly monitoring, they have like hosting in OVH and some other, even some bulletproof servers, but then they switch it to routers. And when they switch it to routers, the routers was in Russia and Ukraine. And we find way that these routers, they doesn't change password, and on router and was this password like admin, and we talk with Russian police and Ukrainian police, and we just grab it like all these routers reconfigured that all traffic was going to us. But then criminals understand that that all traffic going for some strange Danish IP address, and they start DDoSing our sync call, and it was like really huge DDoS. But then they stopped DDoSing and start sending spam emails. There was, but mail from, there was csis.dig. And we received also like, but like first spam run, like also email was a return email. It was csisdk, and we received near 3 million of emails, like bounced emails to us. Then second campaign, spam campaign, they write like from my boss, sent these emails to the security expert, and we get a lot of information, like even from security experts, like from AV vendors. They, we received from you email with some attachment, and even security experts, they even execute some zip executable in the packet in zip, which is really malware. But and we like, if they start to doing that, we try to do something against them. We already know protocol, and we in different ways we try to put like our cross-site scripting to that panel, and we got success. We got access to their panel. And but I don't know, Geriza, it's still, they don't have targets in Brazil, but it's really active in whole world, like in US, UK, Europe, Asia, and they have like even specific model of, we never seen such before. It's like operated by one criminal group, and they invite other criminals like who can steal money, and they like with their targets, with their web injects, and add these web injects to their system already with infected PC. And criminals, you need to pay like 15,000 per month, and you will have access with your web injects, with your target, and you can just steal money, just operate with web injects. And also they're using bots, like the same infected computers they're using to spam. And for us it was strange, because they just infect user. Sometimes they even doesn't check that user was, user was new, and he started sending spam mails. I don't know why they're doing, because they even don't know that user have money on account or not. They just start spamming. Probably like they want to increase amount of bots and don't care about their bots. And this is like some slides of panel. And spam campaign that was from our, like related to us, it was called 1902 UK11. It's common name. The first it's date and month, and it's common for Deriza. And there was in fact they sent zip file with executable inside, and was from they sent near 3 million emails, and successful was infected was only 830 users. It's, and this is location by related to countries, and mostly focused in US, some India, and some other countries. Yep, thank you. That's all. I have any questions?